Yeah, you and me, Lord. You and me. We have a 1 John 4. God is love. Dear friend, dear friend, dear friend, let us love one another, because love comes from God, and whoever loves is a child of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God. For God is love, and God shows love for us by sending His only Son. He sent His only Son into the world so that we might have life through Him. That is what love is. It is not that we have loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the means by which our sins are forgiven. Oh, our sins are forgiven, dear friends. If this is how God loved us, then we should love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in union, lives in union with us, and His love is made perfect in us. We are sure that we live in union with God, and that He lives in union with us, because He has given us His Spirit, and we have seen and tell others that the Father sent His Son to be the Savior, to be the Savior of the world. And if anyone declares that Jesus is the Son of God, He lives in union with God, and God lives in union with Him. Oh, we ourselves know and believe that love which God has for us, God is love, and whoever lives in love lives in union with God, and God lives in union with Him. Love is made perfect in us, in order that we may have courage on the judgment day. We will have it because our life in this world is the same as Christ. There is no fear in love. Perfect love drives out fear. So then love has not been made perfect in anyone who is afraid, because fear has to do with punishment. We love because God first loved us. We love because God first loved us. And if someone says he loves God but hates his brother, he's a liar. For he cannot love who he has not seen. And if he does not love his brother whom he has seen, then the command that Christ has given us is this: whoever loves God must love his brother also. Must love his brother also. Ooh. Perfect love drives out all fear.